Hello everyone, welcome to this session. I have just solved this JEE Main Test 78 and here's the analysis of the physics section. I have regarded one as tough, which you might not find that tough. 18 were medium, 6 were easy. The paper were less time taking and it should be a scoring one. I have termed as medium because there were 2-3 steps or some good concept was there. Otherwise, many questions in the medium category can also be easy if you have thoroughly prepared. So here I think it should be scoring one. So anyone decent in physics should get 60 plus and the one aspiring for top ranks in advanced should get 85 plus in this. So let's start the first question. The XT graph of a particle undergoing SHM is shown below. The acceleration of the particle at t equal to 4/3 seconds is. So first of all, what is the position at 4/3 seconds? So if I write this function, this is a sine function, you can write it as is a sine omega t, phi would be 0. So a is 1 centimeter. Sine of omega, omega is 2π/t, which is 2π/8 into t. So the position at t equals to 4/3 seconds would be 1 centimeter sine of 2π/8 into 4/3, which leaves me with this 2 and 4/8 sine of π/3, which will be √3/2. So it is √3/2 centimeter positive. So acceleration, you know, is minus omega square x, which is minus, you have π/4 whole square into √3/2. So it comes out as minus √3π² / 32 cm/s². So going by the options, it is the D1. This is the first one. Next, in a 1D collision between two identical particles, B is stationary, A has a momentum B before impact. During impact, B gives an impulse J to A, then the coefficient of restitution is. So B gives an impulse J to A, that means A gives an impulse J to B. So what we can write, J would be equal to M into, let's say, VB final. Now, what it also means for the momentum of A, definitely it gives impulse J to it. So because it gives an impulse J to it, so for A, I can say J is equal to change in momentum, that would be in the opposite direction. So I should write MU minus MVA. That is what I can write, assuming the velocity is VA after the collision in the same direction. So it is MU minus MVA. So what we have now, you have to find the coefficient of restitution between the two particles. Okay, and you also have to write this J in terms of P also. So I can write it as J as P minus, let's say P2, and this one is P1, I can say. So what we have now is P1, or coefficient of restitution. Basically what we write, coefficient of restitution, we write it as VB minus VA upon UA. So VB I can write as P1 by M, and what we have this this thing, what you get, P1 by M, VA I can write it as J by M minus U, or you can or U minus J by M, that is the better thing to write, U minus J by M, that is what you can write. And this is what we have, and you can written as P by M, that would be more appropriate, divided by U is P by M. So this M goes, what you have, P1 minus P plus J, okay, upon P. And if you do this, we know P1 is also J. So JJ, this is 2J by P minus 1, that is what we are getting. So it is 2J by P minus 1, so go for option A. So just arrange the variables, it's slightly tricky. Next, the bow of pendulum of mass M length L is distanced 90 degrees from the vertical and gentrily raised in order that the string may not break upon passing the lowest point, minimum strength must be. So you know the maximum tension is at the lowest point, and that would be when it swings like this. What we write at the lowest point, this is tension, this is mg, and you have t minus mg equals mv at bottommost point, which you know is √2gh² / r. R is l and this h is also l, so let it be l itself. So what we have, t minus mg equals, if you solve it, it is 2mg, so t is 3mg. So the minimum tension it should have sustained is 3mg, otherwise if it cannot, it will break. In the circuit shown, each of the resistor is R, equivalent resistance between A and B you need to find out. So first of all, this is A, so I can write this is A, this is A, this is B, this is B. Now, if I write it as C, this will be C. If I write it as D, this will be D. Now these two are in series, no doubt about this. These two are in series, this is 2R, 2R. So let me redraw. So what you have, if I do, let's say between A and C it is R, between A and D it is R. So this is covered, and between C and D we have 2 times R, so that would be parallel. I can say R by 2, this one and this one. And now between C and B I have this 2R, between D and B it is 2R, so it's a balanced Wheatstone bridge, so this would be taken out. So it is 3R, 3R, so it would be 3R by 2, that is 1.5R. This is the R equivalent, that is 1.5R. So just rearrange, it's a balanced Wheatstone one. Next, the circuit shown in the figure consists of two resistors, resistances R1, R2, where they are, here they are, connected to ideal voltmeters V1, V2. Assume that the voltmeter reads delta V is minus E dot DL from A to A between its terminal. A time varying magnetic field B is V naught T exists in a circular region of radius A and it is directed into the plane of the paper. The reading of the voltmeter V2 now will be, what would be the reading of the voltmeter V2? So first of all, what will the voltmeter V2 will read? So first of all, if I do, this field is only in this region, so what we have, the flux, flux I can write it as B into A, so that I can write as B naught T into pi into A square, that is the flux. Now induced EMF you always know is minus d phi by dt, so here B is varying, so it is minus pi A square B naught. This is the EMF that we will have, this is the induced EMF. So the magnitude of the induced current is induced EMF upon what we can say is the resistance, and resistance of the circuit you have, if we will say the complete resistance is R1 plus R2, so it would be pi A square B naught upon R1 plus R2. And what would be the sense? The sense, if you make out, because the field is increasing inwards, so it will have a sense of a outwards term, so it would be like this. This current will be like this, it will be rotating like an anti-clockwise sense here. Now, the voltmeter reading delta V1, we will write it as minus E dot DL from what we can say from A to B, it is what it is sensing. So E dot DL you have to check out. So if E dot DL I have to check out here, you know the current is in this direction, so the field is also in this direction. So if E dot DL I go from A to B, I am going opposite to the field. So it is going to be a positive reading. It is a positive reading, and the value I know is IR, that is IR1, that is pi A square B naught R1 upon R1 plus R2. This is for the first one. Similarly, I am asked for the second one. What will be the second one? Again, here the field I can say would be from A to B, and again I am going from A to B, so it is going to be the negative one here. So it would be minus IR2 here, and minus IR2 here means minus pi A square B naught R2 upon R1 plus R2. So it's a very nice one. One will read positive, one will read negative. So here I'll go for which option? I'll go for, this is R2 one, so this is the option B. This is a very nicely asked question. Next. The mass of a planet and a diameter are 3 times those of Earth, okay? Then acceleration due to gravity on the surface is what we know, g at surface is gm by r square. So this is 3 times, this is 3 times in the diameter, but the radius also, that means 9 times, it means it would be 1 by 3. So it would be 1 by 3, that is 9.8 by 3, approximately 3.3 meter per second square. That's an easy one for you. Next. Car starts from rest, accelerates at rate f through a distance s, then continues at a constant speed for t, and then retards at rate f by 2 to come to rest. The total distance is 15 s. Then now this is a very nice question. First of all, acceleration is at the rate f and retardation is the rate f by 2. So if I draw this vt diagram, always whenever you have this installment type, accelerate, retard, constant velocity, always go for vt diagram. So first it accelerates, let's say for some time, let call this time be t naught. Then it moves at some constant rate and then it retards. Because retardation is half, so slope would be half, and definitely the time it takes to go from, let's say, 0 to Vmax, the time it takes to go from Vm to 0 with half the retardation would be double, that is for sure. You can directly make out, so this is t naught, this is 2t naught, this is what you have got. Now the total distance traveled is 15s, so what I can make out, this distance you are given as s. So if I do this here, here the height is same but the base length is doubled, so this distance will be doubled, that is 2s. That means the remaining one is 12s. So 12s distance it covers during the uniform acceleration. So what you need to remember now, first of all, s is equal to half Vmax into t naught, and now we have this Vm into whatever I can write this time as t, this is the time t. So Vm into t would be equals to 12s. So if I have to do this, it's better to what we can do. 12s is VMT, that means 12 times SS I can write as half VMT naught, that is equal to VMT. So VM, VM goes. So what we have, so S is FT, S is FT, that is wrong. I can directly say 1 by 6 FT square. Let me check it now, first of all. So, okay, in terms of F, I have to do, I don't know why I'm doing this. This was no use. I think this is what we say VMT naught, and this is VMT. So what we have now, we have 6 T naught is equal to T, or T naught is T by 6. So now we can do. This S, you can say applying ut plus half at square, that is 0 plus half, A is F into T square. T square is T naught by 6 whole square. So it is F T naught square by 32. So this is not 32, sorry, 36 into 2, that is 72. So F T naught square by 72. So we'll go for option D. So slightly manipulative one. Next one. Particle of mass M is moving with speed u, strikes a smooth horizontal surface at an angle 45. Rebounds at an angle phi with speed v. If the coefficient of restitution is 1 by root 3, the value of phi is okay. So first of all, check the x components here. So the x components would be equal in magnitude. So here the component was u by root 2, here it would be v cos phi. That means cos phi is, let me write it like this only. This is the first equation. Now for the vertical one, this v sin phi would be equals to 1 by root 3 times the initial one, which is u by root 2. This is the second one. So divide them like this. I have written somewhat not in a proper way. 10 phi would be equals to 1 by root 6 upon 1 by root 2. So that comes out as 1 by root 3. That is what we are getting. So that means phi is equals to 30 degrees. 30 degrees. Yes, phi is equals to 30 degrees. So go for option A. Next. Ideal gas expands isothermally from V1 to V2 and then compressed to original volume V1 adiabatically. The initial pressure is P1, final is P3, total work is W then. So draw this. Isothermally expanded like this from V1 to V2 and then adiabatically compressed. So adiabatic has more slope, so it would be going like this. So it would be like this. So this pressure is P1, this would be equal to P3 here. This is V1 to V2. Clearly, you can see the area under the adiabatic part is more. So, work done will be negative. So, one thing is work done is negative and you can make out P3 is definitely going to be greater than P1. So, go for option C. So, straight away, you have done such questions. Now, 1 mole of an ideal gas taken from A to B by 3 different process A to C to B, A to D to B, A to E to B, the heat absorbed by the gas. So, what we have here? We know delta U is going to be same. Now, the work. WAB is 0, and if I talk about WADB is 0, WACD. If I talk for the WACD, I can do it like this. From A to C, the work done is negative, and from C to B, it is positive. So positive work is more, so that is positive. And going by the same analogy, WAEB will be negative. And delta U we know is also positive, so definitely the maximum heat is absorbed into ACD. So maximum heat is ACD, not ACD, sorry, AEB, ACB. In the ACB, maximum heat is absorbed. So in the process A, the heat absorbed is most. So A is wrong. Least in process B, that is also not right. The same in A and C, not right. Less in C than in B, that is right. Because in the C1, it would be less than delta U, and in the B, it is equal to delta U. Next one. Two long parallel wires carry currents I1, I2 such that I1 is greater than I2. When the currents are in the same direction, the field at the midway point is this. If I2 is reversed, the field becomes this. So the ratio I1 by I2 is. So what we have in the first case, when both fields are opposite, what we have, mu naught I1 minus I2, it would be subtracting upon 2 pi. Let's say both distances d from the wire, that is 6 and 10 to power minus 6. And when they are reversed, the fields will add up. So I1 plus I2 would be equals to upon 2 pi d equals 5, or you can say 30 into 10 to the power minus 6. So take the ratio I1 plus I2 over I1 minus I2 comes out as 5. So what we are left with, I1 plus I2 is 5 times I1 minus 5 times I2. So 6 times I2 equals to 4 times I1. So I1 by I2 ratio, if I talk about, is 3 is to 2. So I1 is 2, I2 is 3 by 2. So go for option C here. Next. Given R1 is 1, R2 is 2, C1 is 2, C2 is 4. The time constant in microsecond for the circuits is okay. So in the first, this is in parallel. So what we have in the first one, this R equivalent would be 1 and 2, that is 2 by 3 ohms. Here it is in series, so the C equivalent would be 4 into 2 upon 4 plus 2. That comes out as 4 by 3 microfarad. So therefore, the tau would be R into C, that is 8 by 9 seconds, microsecond, sorry. So 8 by 9, so we are left with only one choice. So go for D, and you can check for here also, it is R1, R2 is 3, so it would be, let's say, 3, and this will also add up, that is 6, 6, 3 is 18, so it's perfect. Next. Water coming with velocity V drops into a mesh through which 50% of the water passes by, 25% loses entire momentum, 25% bounces back the pressure on the meshes. So because of this 50% zero force, because of this 25%, we say the change in momentum is P. Here the change in momentum would be twice of P. So what we write, F is equal to dP by dt. So what we have for 25%, that is 1 by 4 mv, that is a change. For that 25%, it's 2 times 1 by 4 of mv, that is a total change per unit time. So it's better dm by dt, I should write. So dm by dt, that is what we are getting. This is the change in momentum that we will be getting here. So what we have, this is dm by dt into what we have, this is 1 by 4 dm by dt into 3v that I am getting. Now, so the pressure on the mesh is, so the pressure is a force upon area, and if I write this dm by dt, if you remember, is written as dv by dt times rho. So rho into dv by dt, dv by dt is a into v. So that is a into v into 3v divided by area. So area goes. So what it has, it is 3 by 4 rho v square that I am getting. So option D is the appropriate one. So again, a nice question, but just do what they are asking for. Now, assume that the binding energy per nucleon versus mass number is as shown in figure. Use the plot to choose the correct choice. This similar question has been asked in JEE Advanced as a multiple correct sometimes, I remember. Now, fusion of two nuclei with mass numbers lying in the range 1 to 50. So if you have from 1 to 50, what you can make out, it will again land in here only, so there would be no gain. Because if let's say 20, it will be here only, so no gain, so fusion won't be releasing energy. Now, fusion of two nuclei with mass numbers in the range 51 to 100 will consume energy? No. If you have 51 to 100, let's say 60 and 60, so that 60 and 60 will land up here, so it will release energy, won't consume energy, it would be a favorable one. Fusion of a nucleus in the range 100 to 200 will release energy? No. If this comes here, it will consume energy, it won't release energy. So now we are left with D only. Fission of a nucleus in the range 200 to 260 will release energy when broken into two fragments. Yes, let's say for 221, it would be in 110, that would be a stable one. So it will release energy. So go for option D. So they have slightly modified the options, but this is a question that was asked in JEE Advanced many years back, I suppose. An infinitely long hollow conducting cylinder with inner radius r by 2, outer radius r, carries a uniform current density along the length. The magnitude of the field as a function of radial distances. So what we have, this is a long cylinder, this is inner radius r by 2, outer radius r. So it carries current here like this. So first of all, in the inside region, the field is definitely going to be 0 because I enclosed will be 0. So till r by 2, it should be 0. So we are rejecting this option A first of all. Now, inside this, whenever we will talk about this region, let's say from what I can say, this is drawn somewhere here, let me come back here. So in this in between region, let me draw it like this. So in this in between region, if I do mu naught into I enclosed would be, let's say, J into what I should write, J into pi times R square minus, let me write it again clearly. First of all, what is the current enclosed by this? This would be mu naught. Total current was, let's say, I, or you can say it is J, so that would be pi times R square minus R square by 4. That is what we getting, divided by mu naught I enclosed upon 2 pi R. 2 pi R means R. So definitely it is not going to be exact linear curve from R by 2 to R. So it is not going to be linear, it is not going to be constant. This is wrong. So we are left with this one, and just at R equal to R by 2, it will be 0. So it would be starting from 0, so it won't be clear. So we are left with only the one choice, that is the D1 from here that we can go for, and outside you know it is inverse to R. So again, it's a nicely designed question, you can do this. Next, light of two different frequencies whose photons have 1 and 2.5 eV energy successively illuminate a surface of 0.5 eV ratio of maximum speed. That's an easy one. In the first case, K1 max is 0.5 eV. In the second case, it is going to be 2 eV. That means it is 4 times. 4 times means the speed will get doubled. So it would be 1:2. That's an easy question from photoelectric effect. Now, the atmospheric pressure at the surface of a lake of depth H is P0. If the pressure at half the depth of the lake is equal to 2/3 of the pressure at the bottom of the lake, then the depth is okay. So at the bottom, I will say P0 plus rho GH, and it is 2/3 of this would be this, at that is at P0 plus rho GH by 2. So from here, what we will have now? So you can say 2 by 3 P0 plus 2 by 3 rho GH equals to P0 plus rho GH by 2. So what we have, P0 by 3 there, and here it would be 2 by 3 minus 1 by 2, that you will write it as rho GH by 6. So what you need now, the depth H of the lake. So depth H of the lake would be 2 P0 upon rho G, what I can write. So if I do this, it is 10 to the power 5 into 2, and this is 10 to the power 4, 10 to the power 3 into 10, that would be 20 meters. So they should have written these values. I am taking the standard one. This would be 20 meters. Next. If light travels a distance x in time t1 in air, 10x distance in time t2 in certain medium, then find the critical angle. Okay. So what we can say, the velocity that c in a, let's say in a vacuum or air, if you take it c is equal to what you can write it as, that is x by t1, and this v is equal to 10x by t2. Now what we have, critical angle you write it as sine theta c, it is equal to 1 upon n of medium, and n of medium you write it as c by v, so it would be v by c. So divide this v by c, what you will have, 10x upon t2 upon x upon t1, this x and x goes, this is 10 t1 by t2. So sine theta c is like this. So what we have, sine theta c is 1 upon n that I am getting. So n we go right wrote it as c by v, so it is like this. So we are left with this choice, sine inverse 10 t1 by t2. Next. Which is not true. Resistance of intrinsic semiconductor decreases with increase of temperature. No, with increase in temperature, the resistance decreases. It decreases as it becomes at a higher temperature, their conductivity improves. Doping pure silicon with trivalent gives P-type? Yes. The majority carriers in N-type are holes? No. N-type means negative carriers that are electrons. So C is the wrong one. So it will be the answer. Next. In the electromagnetic theory, the electric and magnetic phenomena are related to each other. Yes. Therefore, the dimensions must also be related to each other. In the question below, E and B stand for dimensions of them. They stand for dimensions of permittivity, permeability. L and T are dimensions of length and time. All the quantities given, and in SI units, the relation between E and B is, you all know, whenever you do that, the speed of light, you know, C or V, you write it as E by B something. So the dimension of E by B, everyone knows, is C, that is speed of light, that is LT minus 1. So going by this, this is an easy one for you. You remember these relations, and these are very important for dimensions. So these are the objective ones. Now the numericals one. From a triangular lamina of side A, mass M, a small triangular lamina made by joining midpoints is cut. The MI of complete about CM is I0. The MI of the remaining lamina is P by Q I0. This is again an asked question. Then find the values of P plus Q, not in this form, but it is objective that was asked somewhere. So first of all, let me see. This length would be A by 2, you all know, this would be A by 2. So if this standalone lamina, I say its area would be original area by 1/4. So its mass would be original by 1/4. Plus side is also becoming half. So we say I would be proportional to this M into A square thing. So M has become 1/4 and A has become half, that is 1/4. So I can clearly say if complete MI is I0, I can say I of this cut part is equal to I0 by 16 based on symmetry. So for the remaining one, I can directly write this would be 15 I0 by 16. So 15 plus 16, that is what you are getting, that is 31. Next, I am doing this because I remember this question. I have done, I generally teach this to the students because students find it difficult for the first time. If an ideal gas at temperature T, the average force that the molecule applies on the walls of a closed container depends on TST to the power Q. A good estimate is, now such questions are always tricky from this KTG, and they are keep on asking these questions. So what we have now, we know force is pressure into area, and pressure is 1/3, rho v rms square, or you typically write it as number of molecules per unit volume upon m into their speed. Speed, let's say we can call it as v rms square. That is what you write typically. So pressure depends on v rms square, and v rms is root t, so that is proportional to t, that I can say. Now force is pressure into area, so that is will also depend on t, so it would be q will be 1. That is the estimate that we can talk about. Next, what we have in the YDSE shown below, two slits are covered with thin sheets of thickness t and 2t and refractive indices 2 mu and mu respectively. The position of central maxima is shifted by a distance of n from the central position of the screen. The value of n is, so what would be the shift? So shift, you know, t1 minus 1 by mu, so that what we have, this is t into 1 minus 1 by 2 mu, and this, that because of that would be 2t1 minus 1 by mu. So what we will have, this is going to travel a farther distance, so it will shift up, and shift would be, if you will going to solve it, shift would be 2t 1 minus 1 by mu minus t 1 minus 1 by 2 mu. That is the shift that we have got. Okay, so this is the additional part difference basically we can talk about. So this is the additional part difference we will talk. So this additional part difference, what we have t, and this becomes t only, this is becomes t only. So now the new one will be here, where we can say that d sin theta matches t. So d sin theta matches t, so sin theta matches t by d, and this is not going to be very large. I can write it as 10 theta, 10 theta is y by d equal to t by d, so y equal to t d by d. So what is thickness? 2 in 10 ki power minus 5 in meters, d is 1, and this is 10 to the power minus 3, so it comes out as 2 into 10 to the power minus 2. So find the value of n. What is n in centimeters? That is 2 centimeters, so answer would be 2. Now the last two questions. Equation of a wave on a string of linear mass density is given by, okay, so looking at this diagram, omega comes out as 2 pi upon 0.04, k comes out as 2 pi upon 0.50. so velocity from the equation is omega by k, so if I divide it, it comes out as 0.50 upon 0.04, 50 by 4, that is 12.5, and you know that is also equal to root of t by mu. Mu is 0.04, so squaring it, t upon 0.04 is 12.5. better write it as 25 into 25 by 4, so t comes out as 25 into 25 into 100, so t directly, t clearly is 6 to what we have. This is going to be too much. It comes out as, okay, into 0.04, it is 1 by 100, not by 100, it is 1 by 100, I have done it wrong, 1 by 100, so it is 625 by 100, so it comes out as 6.25 Newton. So this is 24th. Now the last, consider an elliptically shaped rail. Where is the rail? Okay, PQ. In the vertical plane, OP is 3, OQ is 4, okay. A block of mass 1 kg is pulled along the rail from P to Q with a force of 18, which is always parallel to line PQ. Force is always parallel to line PQ, okay. Assuming no frictional losses, the kinetic energy of the block when it reaches Q is, the value of N is. So this is the rail, and you have put it like this. So I can directly say what would be the change. So the force is acting along this line. So we have to just, what we do, we have to just check the component of the displacement along this only, because every time it would be the component here only that will be working for us. If this distance is 5 meter, so I can directly say work done by force would be F into D. So 18 into 5, that is equals to 90 joule. You can directly go for this. Okay, so whenever you do, let's say it goes is in some displacement like this, and the force is always here, so you have to take the displacement component along this line, that will always come out like this. So this is 18 into 5 is 90 joules, and what you need to know, the kinetic energy, plus it has reached some vertical plane, so height is also delta ug is mgh. So it is 10, 1 into g is 10, 10 and h is 4, that is 40 joules. So we can say WF should be equal to delta UG plus delta K. So 90 minus 40 delta K would be equals to 50 joules. So 5 into 10, so the answer is not 50, it would be 5, I say, in this case. So answer is going to be 5, delta K is 50 joules. So this was today's paper. I suppose it wasn't as tough. It was perhaps an easy one. Thanks for watching. Keep sharing the